So with any mum with an ASD 3 level child that, you know, is not sleeping, or the child is throwing tantrums, screaming, there is hope. For me, stem cell is the only hope. I've tried other things like MERT therapy, homeopathy, and I still follow that nutrition, but this is the only one that seems to work for my son. We go out to restaurants, he's patient, he doesn't scream, he waits for his meal. He also, actually I forgot to mention, after the first round of stem cell, he started reading, which he got into a mild to moderate special needs school, not a severe school, and he was diagnosed severe. So he's doing really well at school. And yeah, and he's sleeping through the night. He plays with his brother. He loves interacting with me. He looks into my eyes. He's very affectionate and a loving little boy. And hope this treatment gives me more. So we went for our first treatment October 2019, before arriving to Biotech, Bangkok. My son was in his own world. He didn't respond to his name. He did not interact with me. He did not interact with anyone. He would scream all day. And I literally mean, he was known from the neighbors as the boy that screamed, but they didn't know about his diagnosis. So having a young child as well, Darien couldn't be in the same room as his brother. So I have no family support in Australia. So I was in one room with Darien screaming for his brother not to be next to him. And then when I'd go to his brother, which was 3 years old at the time, crying for his mum, Darien would be screaming for me too. So I didn't know which child to choose, which was really hard. So I was so desperate to go. When we got to the treatment, I actually enjoyed the fact that my child was taken care of, his food was taken care of, he did therapy, which gave me some time out as well. He did occupational therapy, acupuncture, TMS, hydrotherapy, all therapies included. It was actually a really pleasant experience for all of us. Darien stopped screaming about the second week when we went there, and I thought it was due to the fact that he's away from his brother or he's on holidays kind of thing. But when we got off the plane in Sydney, the boy stopped screaming, period. And that was my main, that was a big gain for me, because my life was horrible with my son screaming all day. And so they were the first steps of, wow, is this treatment really working? Also with Darien, what I noticed as well with the first treatment was Darien was awake from 3 o'clock to 6 o'clock every night, and we would be, either me and my husband would be patting him for 3 hours. From 3 to 6 a.m. and then I'd have to get up at 6:30 for my other child after putting him to sleep. He would be awake 3 hours, no fail, every night. And that happened for a period of 2 years. It was exhausting. As soon as we got back, he still was waking up at night, but gradually it reduced to 1 hour. And then after 4 or 5 months, he has been sleeping overnight ever since. Also, eye contact improved a little, and therapy-wise, we could actually now sit down for an hour with a few sensory breaks and he can focus. And then we did the 2 hours of ABA that we could do, and he was able to sit and perform and listen to simple instructions. The second treatment was in February 2022, unfortunately, because of the pandemic. And that was actually horrible for me, just waiting and waiting for the borders to open, because the first treatment was so successful. With the second treatment, the eye contact improved a lot more. He looks into your eyes now. He follows instructions. He became a little bit, definitely more social. A few mums that swimming tell me that, oh wow, he's so social, because he goes and, you know, he'll kiss a little girl on the cheek, or he'll want to play with neuro kids. But the problem is that because of his limited language or language, they don't play with him, but he tries. Comprehension wise, he improved as well. With the third treatment, for me, was the big one was socialization. As soon as we got off the plane, I think a couple of months, as soon as we got off the plane, my other son's friends came over and they all started jumping on the trampoline and he joined them. And we were like, oh, wow. So the socialization improved a lot. He would swing kids at school in the playground. And the biggest one for me was the number two in the toilet. I tried previously to get him to poo in the toilet. I think it was treatment two, but it was so exhausting that he'd sit on the toilet for ages and do nothing, just be upset. So I gave up on number twos. I think it was 8 months after the third treatment that he decided that he doesn't want to poo anymore in the nappies, and he actually sat on the toilet and started pooing from then. And he's never done a poo in his nappy ever again because he doesn't wear one. So he's fully toilet trained after the third treatment. This is a child with a severe diagnosis, level 3, global development delay. And he does now, you know, he has ADHD as well. He's not on any medication. I think the stem cells have definitely helped him out there. Hi, my name is Susanna. We are from Sydney, Australia, and I'm Darien's mum. I'm just giving a brief update on the gains that we've had since returning from Shenzhen. Today is January the 8th. So the biggest gain we've seen is the FMT. Darien has been constipated since he was 3 years old, severely constipated, where he could not poo without laxatives. He was constipated from 3 to 8 years old, and I see many specialists in Sydney to try to resolve the problem, but it couldn't be resolved. I had to give him Osmolax daily for him to be able to poo. So I decided to do the FMT that's available in Shenzhen, China. And from the 16th of September, 2003, today's the 8th of January, 2004, I have not given my son any laxatives. And he's pooing once to twice a day, and that's healthy poo. So his constipation problem has gone. And I'm really happy about that. It's been years that I thought he would have to be on laxatives forever, really. But now he seems a lot happier. He's not constipated in no longer. So that was a really good gain. We've also noticed this round was really quick actually, because when we arrived in Sydney, a couple of weeks later, I can take him shopping. Before, I would avoid it a bit because he'd want to open packets of food like biscuits, because I don't let him eat that much crap at home. So at the shops, he'll be like, oh God, there's food here. But now we actually go shopping and he helps me scan items. He scans the items, we pay for it, and he understands that you need to do this and then you'll get a little reward in the end. So that's a big gain for me, to be able to go shopping with him. Also, I've noticed with, for example, social, he loves having people around. He thrives on having people around. So we had a Christmas party gathering here, New Year's gathering with a lot of children, and he thrived on that. He actually initiates play. I mean, he tried to play with the neurotypical kids in the swimming pool, on the trampoline. He'll go up to them and give them a little smile and pull them over to go jump with him. So that's really good. I've also noticed he's initiating a lot more. For example, now during his summer break, he would get his pencil case and with coloring pencils and his coloring book and give it to me so we can sit down and color in. He's done that on many occasions. Before, when he was at home, he had no interest in that unless he was doing therapy, but he's actually initiating that type of work to me. I also, this morning, for example, I was really happy. We were playing ball for a very long time. He was just throwing it to me. I was throwing it to him. He was throwing it back to me. He was catching it. He really enjoyed that. There's a lot of joint attention. So I've recently bought Connect Four. So we actually play Connect Four with Darien. And he understands the turn taking. He understands that we need to match four to win. So that's really big for us.
In terms of schooling, at the end of the year, which was in December, the teachers, he got an award for working independently. Now, what the teacher said to me is she assigns him activities and he will sit down and do them happily and not disturb anyone else with a few breaks, but he'll do his work independently. And that's never happened before. He wouldn't do his work independently at school. And he also won a Member of Parliament award because of that. My son has been diagnosed ASD3, Global Development Delay, and ADHD. He's on no medication. So for him to sit down and work independently and want to do the work and finish it is really encouraging. On his school report, they noted that, and they also noted that he knows how to count by twos, he knows how to count by fives, and he knows how to count by tens. Another gain is now is his understanding taking photos. We would take selfies before, but now if I say to him, sit down, smile, and take a photo for me, he'll sit down, smile, and take a photo. So that's a little gain, but that's pretty good for me.